UFT bringing the ball back in. Laurentian looking good at the moment. Trying to get an opportunity, however, Petrucci will grab this one, try to set something up. Laurentian trying to get a shot on net. However, the ball quickly just rolls to Petrucci, and she's able to handle that one quite easily. Quickly passing it over to the defense, trying to get out of their zone. We may have had some technical problems with the audio. So if you're just joining us or just hearing us for the first time in this game, Matt Romer here with Carson Nimmo at Varsity Stadium. Blues up against the Lady V's of Laurentian. No score at the moment. Very close-tilted game, Carson.
It has been. It's been a defensive battle so far here today. And that's something we can expect out of these two teams that have each only allowed one goal so far this season. Each.
Ball out of bounds. Should be Laurentian ball. Samantha Innocent to inbound the ball for Laurentian.
Matt, these are the two top teams in the Eastern Division of the OUA so far. University of Toronto playing three games. They're 2-1 on the season, whereas Laurentian, they played four games. They're 3-0-1. Three wins. With one tie.
Yes, Toronto currently tied with Queens with 6 points. Queens only playing two games so far. Esther Herrero with the free kick. McConville was able to get a header on it. Unfortunately, not a lot of power behind it.
McConville with that outstanding game yesterday, scoring four times in a 6-0 win.
Yes, huge win for the Blues yesterday. Both teams actually coming off big wins yesterday. Laurentian taking down Ryerson. I think the score was 2-0, if I'm correct.
2-0 win.
Dowman trying to get to a ball on the far side, able to keep it in. Nice little slide there. However, it's going deep into the end, and the defense will let that go, giving the ball to the goaltender. Hopefully she can set something up for the Lady V's. Here early, just less than 28 minutes into the first half, no score. Not only is it the top two teams in the East, Carson, it's also both leading goal scorers for the OUA.
Yes, that's right, Matt. We just mentioned Alicia McConville. Oh,
quick opportunity early here for McConville. Oh. Lewis trying to get the ball over to McConville. However, they weren't able to get a shot on net. Again, the Laurentian defense staying strong here early. Couple of missed opportunities, possibly.
So Alicia McConville with the four goals on the season, like I mentioned. But for Laurentian, it's Lisa Watson, number 9, the striker, who also leads the league with four goals in three games. And what we've seen from Watson so far has been a lot of speed on the right side of the field. But so far, unable to have any real scoring chance.
Acerrero with the free kick. Deep in Laurentian zone. See if Lewis or McConville will try to get ahead on it. Oh, Dowman! What a goal!
No, Matt, just offside there. Just offside.
Thank you, Carson. You're right. I was quick to assume that was a goal. Unfortunately, UFT slightly offside, goal called back.
Dowman just threw her airs up in the air after that one, thought she had her third goal of the season.
Definitely a little bit frustrated. That would have been the first goal of the game. Maybe possibly break the ice. UFT still pressing, though. Keeping it contained in the Laurentian zone. Showing the control, the foot speed
that
they showed yesterday. Lewis just a little bit wide to the left.
A great move by Lewis. From what we've seen, if she's got some room to beat defenders, she can be very dangerous, and obviously with a fairly powerful shot.
Another opportunity down in here. And McConville. However, Michelle Philp, goaltender for Laurentian.
Not a bad effort by McConville, though.
Able to make that save.
Her left foot there.
We can hear Anthony Capitosto yelling out guidance for his players. Possibly a little bit upset about the last play. UFT throwing the ball back in. Out of bounds again. This time, Laurentian ball.
Capitosto, a first-year coach for the women's soccer team, the Blues, but actually the fifth-year coach for the men's team, so he's working both the men and the women's team this year, and was actually a Blues player himself in his own right back in the late 90s and early 2000s. An all-star defender.
Yeah, he was on the right side of both. He had two wins yesterday.
Two wins
for the coach.
The combined score of, I think,
10-0.
10-0.
Yes. Obviously, we'd mentioned 6-0 win by the women's side yesterday against Nipissing, and then in the afternoon game, the men also not allowing a goal, winning 4-0, also against Nipissing, against those Lakers. Laurentian trying to get the ball out. However, UFT relentless at the moment. Lewis, possibly an opportunity on the side. However, Laurentian defense
stopping her. Again.
Yeah, she's going to look to possibly cross. Controlling. Getting a shot on net. Nope. Unfortunately, wasn't able to put enough power behind that one to get it on net.
McConville turned around like a corkscrew on that one and tried to put it towards the net. But well defended by Laurentian.
Midfield, Laurentian to throw it in. Still no score with just over 22 minutes left here in the first half at Varsity Stadium. Beautiful Sunday afternoon. Similar to weather what we had yesterday here. No rain in sight, thankfully.
Typical Canadian, eh, Matt?
Yes.
Talking about that weather.
Laurentian trying to get an offensive opportunity. However, the Blues quickly get it out. Downman and McConville quickly running towards the ball. However, Laurentian defense coming up quick to get the ball back out once again. Free kick awarded to Lady V's.
And Matt, it sounds like a few of the Lady V,
Supporters
have made the journey down to the University of Toronto for this one.
Yeah, they may have been here for the weekend due to the game against Ryerson yesterday and UFT today. Both the men and the women probably sticking around.
So far, it's been an extremely favorable schedule for the Blues. They're yet to play on the road this season in their first four games.
Yeah, definitely an asset, maybe even an advantage.
So you got to get the points now. Lewis.
We were talking about that before, about being a home team and possibly having an advantage with having access to all of your players, right, Cars?
That's right. I talked to the Laurentian coach before this one, Rob Gallo, and he mentioned he's got 9 first years on the team, but he was only able to actually travel with 4 of those first years and 18 players overall. So that's another advantage the home team might have in this particular case.
Free kick for the Blues. Laurentian side trying to control, getting the ball out of bounds.
Good pressure
UFT
by Downing.
Throw in. Zukovic throwing into Dalman. And Pitten getting the ball out once again. Zukovic throwing it in. UFT trying to control. Getting it back to their defense. Nice move there by Navdiol.
Oh, got the referee in the head there for a second.
Oh,
geez, almost twice in a row.
Referee's going to have to be on his toes today, so far, what we've seen. Great move there by Machado. Renshin seemed to be struggling a little bit here, as it's been mostly UFT offense. Still no goals here early on. Just under 20 minutes to go here in the first half. Matt Romer here with Carson Nimmo, bringing you today's game. Again, coming up later this afternoon will be the men. The Blues going up against Laurentian. That game should start, I think, about 3 o'clock start, I think, Carson?
I believe about 3:30, I think, Matt.
Okay. And SRL just getting the ball out of danger. Probably a throw-in for the Lady Vs. I guess in that situation, Carson, it's better just to get the ball out than have any offensive opportunity against.
I think so. If in doubt, it's never a bad choice just to kick the ball out of bounds.
Kind of similar to a quarterback just getting rid of the ball.
Exactly, Matt. If in doubt,
throw it out.
Throw it out. Kick it out.
Or kick it out.
I'd like to just take this opportunity to go over the first three games of the season so far for Toronto. They began the season on September 1st with a 1-0 loss to Ottawa. Then on September 1st, they won 2-0 against Carleton. And then yesterday, as we mentioned, a 6-0 victory over Nipissing.
Laurentian trying to put on some offensive pressure here. However, free kick awarded to the Blues. Estorero will try to get something going here. Laurentian trying to get the ball out.
You know, Matt, it's interesting to note that Laurentian's only tie on the season came against Nipissing, a team that Toronto, you know, I'm gonna say walloped maybe yesterday.
Yeah, easily
defeated.
Defeated. Yes, that is interesting to note. Laurentian, as we mentioned, being the first place team, with the Blues tied for second right now with Queens.
Queens with a game at hand, and they have played those two games.
Ball out of bounds once again. Goaltender Philp will have her kick. McConville controlling, but defense being very strong. Something tells me that although many secrets weren't given out by coaching staff, that something must have been said to their Laurentian players about McConville. As we mentioned, coming off of that big 4-goal game, you'd think they'd want to possibly contain her anytime she has the ball.
Oh yeah, I would, maybe have one of your midfielders come back a little bit more than they wouldn't otherwise do, just to put an extra person on Conville. Conville and Dowman seem to be working very, very well together at striker. Well, from yesterday, Matt, we saw some nice give and go plays between those two.
Mm-hmm. Adding Lewis down the far side with her speed, and It's just a great 1-2-3 punch for the Blues.
And on defense for the University of Toronto, they mostly have fifth years. They've got two fifth-year captains on the back end that allowed only 11 goals, four in 16 games last year.
Yeah, that was that would be good for third in terms of goals against, with only Ottawa and Queens having less than the Blues. So a great defensive team continuing here for this campaign. UFT bringing the ball back in. However, Laurentian controls, getting the ball out to midfield. Here comes Adams. Adams getting it up to Innocent. However, ball out of bounds. UFT ball. Just over 14 minutes left to go here in the first half. Varsity Blues up against the Laurentian Lady V's. No score.
University of Toronto, not an overly big team. Their biggest player is actually goaltender Monica Mayer, who's not in this game right now at 5'9". Everybody else is 5'8" or less. But what they lack in maybe size, they make up for with speed.
Yeah, definitely Asia Lewis teams. Being one of those young women with just wheels. Ball out of bounds, Laurentian. Throw in. Jacques getting that ball up. That's Vounderwood crossing. However, UFT defender possibly knocking over one of the Lady V players and taking the ball.
Good non-call in the box there.
Yeah, very aggressive defense on both sides. Not letting anything through. Opportunity for the Blues, stifled again by the defense. Just trying to get that ball out.
I think, Matt, it's going to take a spectacular play to break both these defenses. If we see a goal, it's going to, perhaps take a great individual effort.
Yeah, by the looks of it may just take one goal to win this game. Much different from what we saw yesterday. Closest play we've seen is that offside call against the Blues, where Dauman had found the net.
Third of the season.
Yeah, however, she was probably a step ahead of one of the defenders. Frenchin trying to come out again. Adams, unfortunately, loses possession. And now Machado getting it up to Dauman. Dauman going down the right side. Ball just out of bounds. Goal
strategy
kick coming
there,
up.
Matt, is often get it to the player in the corner. The player from the corner plays it towards the front of the net, and everybody just get to the net, and nothing fancy about it.
Just put on my sunglasses. That makes a big difference, Carson. No more squinting for me. At midfield, Laurentian trying to get an opportunity offensively, going down the right side. Left side, closest to you viewers watching right now online. Jacques fighting against Dauman. Dauman just not giving her an inch.
And we thank you viewers at home watching on sssncanada.ca. We appreciate your support so much. Watching University Athletics on this beautiful Sunday afternoon. Good opportunity here for Laurentian to open the scoring.
Free kick Getting it inside, right? Wow.
Oh, nicely cleared.
Quickly cleared by the defense of the Blues.
Was that McConville, the striker, clearing that?
I think so. McConville and Dowman both playing some pretty decent defense for strikers.
You know, I've never really seen that before, a striker going back into her own box to clear the area. There's that teamwork that head coach Anthony Capitosto was talking about at the beginning of the game.
Mm-hmm. Blues setting something up. Here comes Zikovits. Zikovits coming in. Back to McConville. Oh, the give and go. Zikovits turned away to get back into her defensive position without realizing that McConville was trying to get the go after the give.
Well said, Matt.
Laurentian just struggling to get the ball out. Blues relentless on their attack. McConville on the far side, looking to get across. However, Hinton, who's been strong all game defensively for the Lady V's, getting the ball out. Long strike by the Blues. However, Philp able to grab that one easily.
That was Diana Estorero, and as far as we've seen so far this season, Matt, she's got the best strike on the team.
Yeah, as we mentioned, that would probably be the case as to why she's taking the free kicks for the team. I guess she's the Beckham of the Blues, if you would want to say. Whether or not she can bend it like him, I don't know.
Corner kick opportunity coming up here for Toronto.
Yeah, McConville had been tripped up a little bit. Ball out of bounds. And yes, as you said, Carson, corner kick coming up for the Blues. Estorero about to set this one up. Free kick. Blues. Just over 8 minutes to go here in the first half. Wrench inside, getting some quick water. Oh, we've got a sub, actually. Injury, possibly, to Leanne Adams, who will be replaced by Stacy Watson.
Number 12, Stacy Watson.
No relation to Lisa Watson.
as far as
we know. Corner kick going actually over top of the back of the net. And it'll be a goal kick coming up for the Lady V's.
You know, it's funny, Matt. Have you ever actually seen a goal come off a corner kick before? It's pretty spectacular. Some players able to actually bend it into the net from there, throwing off the goalkeepers. But
yeah, it doesn't happen too often, though, does it?
Very rare play.
Ball out of bounds, lose possession. Into McConville. McConville trying to get the ball over to Lewis. However, it's pretty clogged over there on the right side. Over on the right to Dowman, however, just a little bit too far for her. And Lady V's goal kick on the way.
Just under 7 minutes remaining in this game. Plus maybe perhaps, or I'm sorry, in this half, and then perhaps a little bit of injury time. Shouldn't be too much injury time, Matt, maybe 1 or 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Wrenching, trying to get the ball out. However, Dowman and McConville keeping it in. Ball kicked out of bounds by Machado.
Great work by the ball girls in this game.
Yes, unfortunately, we don't know what team it is, but there seems to be a young team that is
lending their time to Ontario University Athletics, which is great to see.
I'm sure very exciting for them. They look to be under 10 years old, I think.
They probably would, you know, aspire a little bit to be these players at some point later on in their career, maybe.
Exactly, I would agree.
Excellent role models for them.
Mm-hmm. All out of bounds once again. UFT ball. free kick to the Blues. Esserero taking place. Blues trying to get.
I think Esserero might go to the net on this one. She's fully capable.
Ball's up from McConville. Oh. However, just missing the header. Ball out of bounds. 5 minutes left here in the first half. Score deadlocked at zero.
Good effort from McConville there. Just barely missed it, maybe by a couple inches of getting her head on that one.
Blues bringing it back into their own end, controlling it on defense. Esterero, once again, just great patience. UFT bringing it out of their end. Unfortunately, a little bit too far for Dowman. And the Lady V's trying to clear. Here is Stacy Watson being very hard on the ball. Watson again on the close side here. Trying to get past Zikovitz. However, great defense. With no shot on net.
Good D by Zikovitz.
Jacques to corner kick coming up for Rene Jacques, the Lady V's. A late goal at this point in the first half might be huge going into halftime.
I think so. It might only take that one goal that's going to be the difference maker in this game.
Oh, cross. Laurentian was able to get a head on it, however, off to the right, just wide of the net. Goal kick coming up for Petrucci. She passes off to Esterero. She'll try to get something set up here. Over to Zikovitz. Zikovitz looking for McConville. Back to Zikovitz. Getting it over to Lewis. However, just a little bit too far. Goaltender quickly grabbing that. And settling down her team. Big boot by the goaltender. Laurentian trying to regain possession. Ball out of bounds. It'll be Laurentian ball. Big throw in. However, Rose Fatta wasn't able to get ahead on the ball. That was quickly cleared by the Blues.
Yeah, it looks like the University of Toronto is playing, a 4-4-2. Four on defense, four on midfield, two up front, or rather, maybe three up front.
That's possibly their three strikers, I would say, Cars?
Yes. Yes, that being McConville. Who else have we got now?
Lewis. And Dowman.
And Dowman, yes.
Here, Lewis having a quick break on the far side, trying to bring it down. However, two defenders right on her. Ball just going wide to the left. There hasn't been a lot of space for the strikers, however. Defense has been kind of glued to them.
Laurentian defense allowing only one goal in four games so far this season. And holding the fourth down extremely well.
We've got less than 2 minutes to go here, plus injury time in the first half. Varsity Blues 0, Lady V 0. And what's turned out to be a very, very tight contest. As we mentioned off the top of the broadcast, these are the top two teams in the East Division of the OUA standings. Both looking to possibly cement their standing against one another. Quick opportunity for Laurentian here. Watson coming down the right side. Back over to Fatta. Fatta getting a shot on net. However, Petrucci finding no difficulty grabbing that one. If these happen to be some of the top teams in their division, a win could be quite big confidence going into any further matchups later on in the year.
Yeah, I think so. Even though it's early on in the season, it's, you know, there's only
16 games
throughout the regular season. So, you know, every game counts that much more. And so far, you know, in the East, the three class teams are really Laurentian, Queens, and the University of Toronto. Queens, of course, winning the OUA championship last season.
And as we mentioned yesterday in our broadcast, Eilish McConville, a fifth-year transfer student from Queens, so she tasted victory last year, and hopes to bring that experience to the Blues this season. Blues trying to control in the defensive end, and they are able to. Gonzalez getting the ball up, trying to get it to Lewis, however, defense intercepting. Machado now with the ball for the Blues, trying to get it over to Dowman, however, a little bit too far for her, ball rolling out of bounds. Goal kick should be coming up. First half should be wrapping up momentarily. Out of bounds. Blues ball. It was Stacy Watson just missing the ball from the goaltender. Sikovits bringing the ball in for the Blues. Possibly looking for McConville. Ball out of bounds once again. And that wraps us up here for the first half. Varsity Blues 0. Laurentian Voyageurs also 0. No goals scored here in the first half.
Halftime score, Laurentian Lady V 0, Toronto Varsity Blues 0. Just a reminder, fans, please stay off of the field and track during halftime and after the game. Thank you for your cooperation.
I expect there maybe to be a little more offense than we saw, although, Matt, the defense is spectacular on both sides.
Yes.
Greetings, loved ones.
Not letting anyone.
Let's take a journey.
I know a place where the grass is really greener. Warm, wet, and wild. There must be something in the water.
Coach is meeting up here at midfield, discussing something with the referee. Both coaches seem to be okay with what was decided. That would be nice if we could have some of the players mic'd up, wouldn't it, Cars? Unfortunately, we're not at that point in our broadcasts.
No, we're not that big time yet, Maddie.
All right, well, hopefully you'll join us here for the second half. We'll have our 15-minute intermission, and we'll be back to bring you what looks like to be a cool second half between the two teams. Once again.
I love the most, I mean the ones, I mean like she's the one. Kiss her, touch her, squeeze her bones. The girl's afraid she drive a Jeep and live on the beach. I'm okay, I won't play. I love the bay just like I love LA. Venice Beach and Palm Springs. Summertime is everything. Homeboys banging out. All that ass hanging out. Bikinis, bikinis, martinis, no weenies. Just the king and the queenie. Katie, my lady. Look at here, baby. I'm all up on you, cause you represent California.
Man.
Welcome back here to Varsity Stadium. Matt Romer here with Carson Nimmo. And we're just about ready to get underway for the second half here with the Varsity Blues taking on the Laurentian Lady V's. No score at the half. Looking like a very tight contest so far, Carson.
Yeah, so far in the game, 6 shots for Laurentian on goal. All 6 tries they had were on goal. And for the University of Toronto, 7 tries on goal, 3 of them being shots. So these two teams have been very, very evenly matched, not giving an inch out there today.
One little correction I'd like to make. The goaltender for Laurentian is actually named Michelle Philippe, or Philippe. I was making the mistake earlier as some of our information was incorrect. U of T controlling early. Jackie Miklovich coming down the side. Here she goes. She's got possession once again, trying to get it in into the box. Offside Blues. Goal kick coming up for the Lady V's. Both sides probably looking to get off to a quick start here in the second half. Ball out of bounds once again.
Yeah, when I talked to head coach of Laurentian before the game, Rob Gallo, the thing that he mentioned was University of Toronto, we're going to have to beat them today because they've got so many players, you know, he mentioned that are banged up. So I think, you know, I don't think Laurentian would be disappointed if they walked away with a tie today on the road. That would give them 11 points on the year and the University of Toronto 7 points on the year. But, Matt, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. The second half has just started.
Laurentian bringing the ball in. However, U of T defense again. Quick to get the ball out. Laurentian trying to set it up with the D. However, the ball will go out of bounds. Blues ball.
Laurentian coming off a 2-0 win against Ryerson yesterday.
As for the Blues, they had a shellacking of the Nipissing Lakers 6-0. Here at Varsity Stadium.
And only allowing 1 shot on goal
For the entire game.
For that entire game.
Definitely a one-sided affair. Ball out of bounds again. Petrucci with the goal kick for the Blues.
For Nipissing, you know, yesterday, Matt, to their credit, you know, they have 9 first years on their team. And, you know, it might be more of a rebuild for the Nipissing team.
The Lakers, you're right.
Whereas these two teams playing today are both, I think, capable of winning the whole OUA championship this year. Queens winning it last year. And the University of Toronto maybe wanting to go a little farther this year. They got upset in the first round of the playoffs last year.
By those Nipissing Lakers.
By the Nipissing Lakers, yes.
Great goal kick by Laurentian, getting it deep into Blues territory. However, they're able to control the ball and get it back to Petrucci, who's looking to set something up with Diol. However, intercepted by Watson. Watson, unfortunately, able to cross in front. Blues ball out of bounds. That should be a corner kick coming up for the Lady V's.
Sarah Petrucci playing goaltender for the Blues. She's a first-year student studying criminology.
That would be Rene Jacques taking the corner kick for the Lady V's. Quite possibly a good opportunity here early in the second half. Again, the Blues defenders are able to stop the pressure, getting the ball out quickly to midfield. However, Lady V's controlling it, looking to set something right back up.
Notice on that instant, Matt. Oh, we got a quick chance here.
Yeah, Lewis coming down the left side, showing that quick speed she displayed yesterday. Again, patience, looking to set something up, looking for someone to pass off to, a little give and go. Mikulovich unable to run down the ball, ball out of bounds. Lady V's will take possession.
Just like to mention on that last sequence, the Blues, with all of their players inside their own box, even their strikers.
Yeah, being very, very cautious on defense. As we mentioned in the first half, it may just be a one-goal game.
Even a 0-0 game isn't out of question at this point.
Yeah, this is more typical soccer style.
I think it just goes to show you, you know, how great these two teams are.
Blues trying to get the shot on net. Unfortunately, Laurentian able to clear the ball. But the Blues bringing it back in.
Oh.
Estorero trying to get a shot on net. However, Machado in the way, deflecting off her leg. What I was going to say, Carson, is that today's game is more of a what we expect from soccer. Low scoring.
Yesterday
was just
a different story.
Oh, basically winning by a touchdown, 6 points.
Oh, nice move.
Great move by McConville.
Oh!
Goal for the Blues. We've got our first goal of the game here, folks.
Goal scored by number 17, Jessica Fantozzi.
Varsity goals. First goal scored by number 17, Jessica Fantozzi. Assist by number 3, Eilish McConville.
Fantozzi with the first goal of the game. McConville getting the ball to her quickly for that strike. Well, we had just finished saying that this could be a one-goal game, and the Blues are able to strike first.
Yeah, Jessica Fantozzi with her second goal in 2 games. She scored 1 in a 6-0 win yesterday.
Blues looking to put more pressure on and keep this going. Homeside fans very pleased with that first goal.
And I think that's what it takes, Matt. You know, Alicia McConville able to, you know, display a beautiful individual effort, beating 2 defenders before feeding Fantozzi. Sometimes that's what it's about, Matt, in soccer. You know, if you can just give yourself a little bit of room, especially in tight.
And being unselfish, yeah.
And being unselfish, as the Blues have been, you know, their head coach stressing teamwork. dismissing almost the four goal game by McConville yesterday.
Yeah,
saying that it was a team effort,
as well as also dismissing the fact that they had won by six goals. That didn't seem, when we spoke to him prior to the game, that didn't seem something that he'd been concentrating at all on. It was a win. Mistakes were made. Learn from those mistakes and move on.
And also, Matt, in terms of strategy, you know, we asked him, do you change your game here today against a very, very good Laurentian team? And he said, he kind of shrugged his shoulders and said, no, we're just gonna do what we do, and maybe keeping things simple is the secret to success so far for the University of Toronto.
McConville here having a quick opportunity, trying to get it up to Dowman. Dowman tipping it forward, however, the goalkeeper coming out, and Phillip grabbing the ball. Laurentian now with a break of their own, possibly on the far side. However, Zikovits trying to keep her contained. Ball out of bounds, goal kick coming up for Petrucci.
No, Matt, not just a beautiful facility here at the University of Toronto. It being revamped a few years back. And just the artificial turf, the facility for the players couldn't be better.
Fada trying to get the ball, feed it in. Unfortunately, wasn't able to thread the needle. And the Blues recovered the ball and now quickly getting it up to Lewis down the side. Ball out of bounds. Should be Laurentian ball coming up. Laurentian bringing it back in. Oof. However, getting it back to Estorero, who again, looking very, very patient back there in the back end for the Blues. Ball going back to Phillip. Big boot from her. However, ball out of bounds once again. Blues ball. Almost an opportunity there for the Blues. But again, defense. Quickly getting that ball out of the danger zone. I say danger zone, all I can think of is Top Gun. I was about to sing a couple of notes for us there. I had to refrain myself.
One of my favorite movies probably of all time.
I would have to agree with you. Yeah, same for me, buddy.
Can I be Tom Cruise, though? I'll be Tom Cruise. You can be the other guy.
You know what? I won't be Goose. I'll be Iceman. I'll be your competition.
Okay. All right. Well, as they say, never leave your wingman.
Ball out, Laurentian, to throw the ball back in here. Deep in the Blue zone. Hopefully looking to tie this one up for the Lady V's. Trying to get a shot away, but
look
relentless
at that smothering
defense. Yes. Just smothering. Not even allowing them to get a shot off. A shot does get through. However, Petrucci was there to make the stop.
And of course, just as importantly, not allowing a rebound on that play with Laurentian defenders, or offenders, I should say, coming in.
Blues bringing it out slowly. Getting it up the middle to Machado. A little bit too far for Fantozzi. However, ball out of bounds. Blues ball.
I can hear Anthony Capitozzo from over here directing traffic for his forwards.
Yeah, we're on the complete opposite side of the field, and yet we're still able to hear him yelling.
Oh.
Quick opportunity there for McConville. However, the chip shot was easily handled by the goaltender. We've got just over 32 minutes left here in the second half. UFT Blues up 1-0 over the Laurentian Lady V's. But however, they've got a quick opportunity coming down on the right side. But unfortunately, wasn't a lot of power behind that shot. And Petrucci either easily smothers that ball. now controlling traffic with her D, trying to get something up, set up, that is. Esterero bringing it up to McConville. A little bit too far for her. However, Blue still control. Machado. Lewis trying to stay on that ball. Wrenching, controlling once again near midfield. That's Lisa Watson. As we mentioned before, in the first half, Lisa Watson, goal scorer, leading goal scorer for the Lady Vs with four, tied with McConville in their division. McConville obviously getting four yesterday.
You know, if you added up McConville's assists, you know, she's, even though she has those four goals, she's been one of the better playmakers for the University Blues as well.
Yeah, those the three strikers for the Blues are very, very unselfish. As we said, and something their coach stresses very much.
Something great to see, especially so early on in the season. The camaraderie there between the University Blues. They're almost like a family. You know, Matt, when you play on a team sport, you don't only hang around with these players during games and in practice. You know, they're also your friends, the people that you go to when you're in trouble, the people that maybe you study with on occasion too.
I was just about to say, especially when you're in university, they become secondary family for some.
Yeah,
spending so much time with them.
And if you're a first year student, you know, it makes it maybe the homesickness that you're not used to go, you know, be that much easier to deal with.
Agreed. Ball out of bounds, Laurentian to throw in. Close to just over midfield. That was Melnick with the throw in. Oh. Miklovic going down hard, looking to actually possibly hitting her head on the turf, but she's able to shake that off. Tighten up her ponytail and she's ready to go. No harm, no foul.
Oh.
However, Lisa Watson from the Lady V speaking to the ref, as well as Asia Lewis from the Blues. Just a quick discussion going over what's just transpired.
I think a good job by the referee there. Just make sure there's no hard feelings to be had and
keep the game clean.
Keep the game nice and clean. Nothing, no silly stuff going on.
Mr. Arrow with a great kick. Machado trying to control. Just past midfield for the Blues. Back over to McConville. McConville looking to set something up. Going to the far side to Dowman. Getting it back in the middle.
Oh.
Wow. Lewis going up for the head. Colliding with the goaltender of Lady V's, Phillip. She's looking a little bit shaken up.
Oh, there's their first card of the game. A yellow.
Wow. Yellow card given to Asia Lewis. That was quite the...
Yeah, that time,
quite the collision.
Didn't give an inch to the University of Toronto forward there.
But again, these girls, you know, from my experience with soccer, when somebody gets hurt, they act like they've been shot with a bullet.
Not in this case.
Not in this case at all. These girls are tough. They are up and ready to go within seconds.
You know what, Matt? That's a wonderful point because you see, you know, maybe when you watch TV with some of these.
Some of the professional soccer has been ridiculous.
Teams are diving all over the place trying to, you know, get calls their way, but none of that here in the
OUA. No, these girls are tough. Laurentian trying to control offensively, trying to get something going. However, free kick awarded to the Blues. Think possibly a foul on Laurentian.
So far, out of the four halves that we've broadcasted, the two games, this has been the most competitive, I think, Matt.
I would have to agree with you, Cars. First half was good, though. We're just under 28 minutes to go here in the second half. The Blues leading 1-0 here in the first of two games. being broadcast from Varsity Stadium. The men coming up later this afternoon, also taking on Laurentian. That game will be broadcast to you by Adam Rupkowski, as well as Paul Shaughnessy. And not to be forgotten, part of our team, Joanna Hawkshaw. She's definitely
braving the elements.
Matt. Yes, braving the sun, taking on sunburns on only one side of her body.
Good for her for coming back out for this game.
Yeah.
Today we saw her this morning and thought, oh geez, but no, just as tough as the players out there.
We got a substitution for Laurentian. That looks like Lisa Watson actually being substituted out. Their leading scorer, as far as I know, still trying to see who it was brought in. I think that's Celine Valiquette taking her place. Also striker for the Lady V's.
Rob Gallo talking to the referee right now, I think pleading his case for some of the non-calls that have been happening to his Laurentian team. And when we talked to him before the game, you know, he seemed quite competitive about this match. This being definitely their Laurentian's toughest test yet so far in the season, in their fifth game.
Free kick for Lady V's coming from their defender. One of their defenders. Getting it up to... Oh, I was mistaken. I thought that was Lisa Watson that had been taken off, but I think it was Leanne Adams. So their leading scorer is still on the field for the Lady V's. From the distance that we're sitting at, 8 and 9, looking very similar. Need to get some binoculars for us here, Carson.
What about those sunglasses, Matt?
Yeah, sunglasses
are
working.
Do they make a difference?
Unfortunately, they're not prescription sunglasses. Not helping out the vision any more than...
You got to get your stuff together here, Goose.
Yeah, I do. Lewis coming back at midfield to grab possession of the ball for the Blues. Trying to set it up, getting crossing over to Dowman on the far side. Dowman possibly looking...
Fancy footwork.
...for McConville. However, intercepted by the Lady V's. And they're able to bring it out back to midfield. But the Blues taking back possession. A little bit of back and forth here. Who wants it? Lisa Watson coming, bringing it up. However, stop there on the far side.
Nice interception
by Miklovich. Miklovich bringing it in. Over to Dowman. And, possibly another opportunity here for Celine Valiquette. As we mentioned, she just came on. She's probably got some fresh legs as she goes down the far side, trying to keep that ball in. However, out of bounds, Blues ball. Fresh legs at this point of the game. Possibly maybe an advantage, Cars?
Yeah, I think so. As it gets late in the game, you know, soccer being 90 minutes, stamina is such an important part of soccer. Some of these athletes, you know, it wouldn't be a bad thing for them to, you know, go out and go for a jog and hit the bike sometimes. Endurance, such an important part of soccer, but...
Well, possibly an opportunity here for the Lady V's. Watson losing control of the ball. Oh! Wow. But keeping the ball in for her side. That was Miklovich just colliding hard with Watson. And ball slowly going out of bounds. Diol just letting it slowly roll across the line, giving possession to her goaltender. Goal
Good
kick coming
play
up.
Good from Diol there, just slowing the pace down. At this point for Toronto, obviously they want to be defensive-minded because one goal right now looks like it could be the difference. If the University of Toronto is able to hold on to this game, they would only be behind Laurentian by 1 point for first place in the East with a game at hand.
Yes, because Laurentian, this is This is Laurentian's fifth game. Is that what we stated?
This is Laurentian's fifth game of the season.
Yeah, and only the fourth for the Blues.
Queen's University actually undefeated on the season after their first two games, so we can't forget about them, the Golden Gales.
Last year's OUA championship team. Ball out of bounds deep in the Blues territory. Laurentian to throw the ball in. Lisa Watson stepping back quite a bit from the line, possibly to get a good running start for the toss. Setting something up. Rose Fata trying to get to the ball, but a little bit too far for Celine Valiquette. Goal kick coming up for Petrucci and the Blues.
You know, Matt, it's amazing. In almost 6 hours of play so far this season, the Blues have only allowed one goal. That's pretty outstanding on defense.
I would have to agree with you.
So I should mention that defense, that stellar defense, led by Captain Nav Diol, also Captain Jackie Miklovich, and Deanne Estorero. Very, very solid for the Blues.
Blues bringing it into Lady V's zone.
Oh, fancy move.
Fancy footwork by McConville. McConville over to Lewis. Back to McConville. Gets a shot on net, but easily handed by Phillip of the Lady V's. She's allowing players getting set up. And a big boot from her right across midfield. However, the Blues are able to gain possession again. Downman on the far side getting it back to her D, setting something up. A little bit of back and forth here. But the Blues come across with it. Now Miklovich trying to bring it in. Getting it back to Estorero. Back over to Diol. Diol taking her time. Looking for McConville. McConville possibly looking for a little give and go. Back over to the far side to Downman. Downman getting it in the middle. But a little bit too far for Fantozzi. And the Lady V's goalie quickly gobbling that one up.
For the University of Toronto, they were 8-4-4 last year during the regular season, and it wouldn't be a far stretch to say that they would definitely like to do better than that this year, and so far putting on a great athleticism in this year.
Diol slowly getting it up to McConville, a little bit too far for her as Laurentian D quickly getting on that ball, getting it out. Jacques on the far side trying to get it up for Stacy Watson. We can hear the coaches giving directions to their players. Here with just under 20 minutes to go in the second half, things tightening up even more.
You can feel the intensity out there, Matt, as this game winds down.
Up to the far side to Miklovich. Getting into McConville. But Lady V's D getting that ball quickly out of the way. Out of bounds.
Matt, I think if you're a Blue, that 6-0 win yesterday just would have boosted your confidence up and, you know, made you that more confident going into today's game. And
agreed.
You know, just meant it, you know, with any sport, so much of it is mental.
Look at McConville right now with the fancy forward getting it over. Oh, shot blocked by the defense. Ball didn't even get to the goaltender. That was a great opportunity lost for the Blues. Yeah, back to what you were saying, Carson. You'd think just being a teammate of McConville, knowing that this is her first year with the Blues, she's transferred over from Queens, and as a teammate, you see her score 4 goals. You've got to be feeling pretty good about her and, you know, her being on your team.
And, you know, you would think the way that McConville's been playing, that she's been playing for the University of Toronto for all those 5 years, because she's been getting along with her teammates so well.
Yeah, definitely quick chemistry, as we've seen in these two games this weekend. Carson, we've been fortunate to join the Blues for the weekend. Yes. We'll continue throughout the season. We weren't able to get with them for the first couple of games, but we've joined them here in the third game yesterday, and now they're fourth. And looking forward to the season to come.
And as far as we know, we should be here for most of the home games played by the Blues this season.
Intercepted by the Lady V's.
And hopefully the playoffs, too.
The Blues, D, relentless, getting the ball out. Machado taking her time, feeding it through to McConville. Back to Machado, getting a shot on. However, not too much power behind that. And Phillip is able to grab the ball. Goal kick coming up for her. Big boot once again past midfield. A little bit too far for the forwards and dribbling back to Petrucci in the Blues net.
Esther Arrow signaling there. Slow things down.
Yeah, with just over 16 minutes to go, you don't want to possibly rush something and make any mistakes, do you?
No, I don't think so. And, you know, so much different in soccer when it's 3 points for a win, one for a tie. That's a two-point swing here.
An opportunity here for Watson down the right side. She was able to get a good kick off. However, Petrucci was able to handle that, bring that in. And
Watson had a chance for number 5 there on the season. But so far, she's the leading player for Laurentian, but she's been stymied today by that outstanding
Lewis
defense.
Lewis trying to find the ball around her, not sure where it is. Laurentian D, quick on that ball to get it out. Blues ball, bringing it in. Miklovic over to Machado. Machado battling hard against Rose Fata. Machado over to McConville. McConville, dipsy doodles. Oh! Hard foul on McConville. We have got a penalty shot coming up for McConville. She actually scored yesterday in the game's only penalty shot that we saw. Right, Carson?
Yes, and I think that was her fourth goal of the game there yesterday. She placed it in the bottom left-hand corner. So, you know, if Laurentian did any studying maybe of this game, they would know where she's going to go, but I doubt it.
This is a big opportunity here for the Blues with just over 14 minutes to play here in the second half. This possibly could seal the win. Scores! Goal for the Blues.
Goaltender guess.
Alish McConville coming up huge with the
Ville.
And that puts McConville at the league lead in goals so far this season with 5. All of them coming in one weekend. Jeez,
quite the weekend for her. Showing no rust early on in the season. Blues now up 2-0 here with just under 14 to go in the second half. Laurentian's side stymied so far by the relentless defense from the Blues, led by Esther Arrow.
I think Esther Arrow may be captain of the future. She's a third-year player. As I mentioned, there's two fifth-year players on the back end that are the captains right now. And I think the University of Toronto building from defense to offense. Defense first, of course.
What we can see now is the Blues just looking to keep possession, taking their time, not forcing anything. Obviously, with just over 12 minutes to go, they're not in need of another score. They could sit back easy with a two-goal lead and take their time and let Laurentian force the pace. However, they do have an opportunity quickly here. Downman on the far side trying to get it into Lewis. But the Laurentian D quick to stop the Blues. However, Mikulevich possibly with an opportunity. And the Lady V is just getting that ball out of the way. Throw-in coming up for the Blues. Olivia Gonzalez getting it back to Estorero. Estorero with a big boot. Wide, far wide to the right.
So far in this game, it's been, you know, possession. I mentioned yesterday is so important. And for the second half, it has been the University of Toronto with the possession for most of it.
Yeah, we don't have the stats right now in front of us, Carson, but I would say the same thing for shots in net. We'll get that information for you as soon as we get that on hand. But definitely the Blues are pressing. One goal here in the second half, one in the first, with a 2-0 lead with just over 11 minutes to go here in the first game of the afternoon. As we mentioned before, the men coming up later around 3:30. Also taking
on the field right now, Matt.
Yeah, they are. They're getting warmed up. We've got the Blues on the left. The Voyageurs coming up here on the right. Oh, small mistake there for the Blues as the ball was deflected out of bounds as Mikulevich was wide open on the near side. Lady V's bringing the ball back in. Lisa Watson trying to get ahead on it. Out of bounds. Watson quickly bringing it back in. Possibly with an opportunity catching the Blues off guard. But no. Defense just very, very strong. Not allowing even a shot on net. Blues settling things down. However, Laurentian trying to press. Needing to score two with just under 10 minutes to go here.
You can hear the coaches yelling, settle it, settle it.
Oh, there we go. Little header from McConville up to Downman. A little bit too far for her. Over to the goalie who boots one up to midfield, but Blues regain possession quickly. Looking very, very strong here in the late going. Not looking like...
So much for losing a bit of steam here at the end.
Not looking like they're losing steam at all. Blues looking very, very good this weekend.
You know, Matt, we haven't mentioned too much about the midfielders in this game, but they have been doing an excellent job coming back and helping out in their own end. Helping those all-star defenders out for the Blues.
Yes, bridging the gap between the strikers.
Exactly.
Lewis fighting hard here along the sidelines right in front of us.
Out of all the players that I've seen, Lewis has been the most physical for the Blues and extremely good at intercepting the ball and putting pressure on.
McConville just missing an opportunity to get a shot on net. Lady V's controlling now, trying to get it out. However... Hitting their own player with the ball. Machado getting it over to McConville. McConville looking for Fantozzi, but a little bit too far. Scooped up by the goalie. She's going to boot this one just past midfield. With Vanderwood looking to control. Getting it up to Watson, but maybe a little bit too far for her. And the goaltender is able to slide in and grab the ball. No chance for Lady V's for a shot there. And again, the Blues breaking out very quickly, not wasting any time. But the Lady V's there to counter. Ball out of bounds. Blues will bring it back in. We've got just over 7 minutes to play here in the second half, here at Varsity Stadium. Matt Romer here with Carson Nimmo. on a beautiful Sunday afternoon.
University of Toronto's fourth game of the season. Next week, they're going to be playing Ryerson University in Toronto, and that's going to be their first game on the road.
On the road, but really not on the road, is it there, Carson?
Well, no, it's just around the corner, I guess.
Yeah, I think the only thing that would change would be the fact that they're considered the visiting side. But yes, any in terms of having players available or fans to come out and support, it's like a New York-based team facing off against one another.
Exactly. Yeah. And this facility here, and it's just so excellent to play at. Next week, having to go on the road, I don't think too much would change in terms of strategy, any of that. They just need to continue to keep things simple, and they should be all right.
Yeah, Ryerson would be looking for their first win. They're 0-2-1 to start this early season. But today it's been between Laurentian and Toronto, it's been all Toronto with their two goals. Laurentian has had their opportunities, but have not been able to get past either Toronto defense or goaltender Sarah Petrucci.
Yes, after this game today, I think the biggest test for the University of Toronto after this match here today is going to be against Queen's University in Kingston on September 25th. Queen's University, the champions last year and undefeated so far this year.
Laurentian bringing it back to the goaltender, looking to set something up. Just over 5 minutes to go. Not a lot of time to score two goals, and that would only be for a tie.
Matt, after this game here today, the Blues don't return home until October 8th against Queens.
Wow, so that's almost a month.
Well,
that's
almost a month, Matt.
By having, by having four home games to start the season, well, you're going to have a lot of away games coming right up right after. So
they've done very well to get what right now is looking like 9 points out of a possible 12 in the first four games.
Laurentian throwing the ball in. Just in front of us. Hackett battling it out with the Blues midfielder. Getting back to Pitten, who's able to get it back to her goalie. But Blues right on the Lady V's right now, not giving them much space to get anything going.
Look at that, Matt. Every time Laurentian has the ball at midfield, the Blues are just all over them, not giving them an inch of room. Great defending.
Lady V's bring the ball in. Oh, sorry, free kick. Firing it towards the net, looking for some kind of deflection. However, Blues control again, getting it back to Petrucci. She's taking her time. Actually picking up the ball to give her even some more space to get something going. Just throwing the ball over to Diol. Diol kicking it up to Lewis. Lewis mishandling it, but back to Blues possession with Miklovic bringing it up for Lewis. A little bit too far for her as the Lady V's regain possession. Getting up to Watson. Watson trying to crisscross. However, the Blues intercept, getting it back to their goalie again, slowing down the pace with just over 3 minutes to go. Right now, it's just, I guess, a bit of a survival for the Blues. No need to press for any more offense. Whoa, that could have been a very bad situation. Diol was sending the ball back to her goaltender. However, I don't think she was ready. Missed the ball. However, it just went to the right of the net.
Maybe just a tiny bit of inexperience for Sarah Petrucci on that play. Her being a first year, had her head up, wanting to advance the ball, but kind of just lost sight of it there for a split second.
Corner kick coming up here for Jacques on the Lady V's. They need a quick one here, Cars, if they've got even a chance of tying this thing up.
They do. They've got almost all the defense inside the box.
Oh, ball crossed. But the shot that was taken wide of the net to the left.
I think if you're Laurentian right now, you want to try to push everybody up, kind of get some of the defense more involved, obviously the midfielders.
Yeah, as we can see, defense just past the midfield line with Petrucci to give her kick. Lady V's control. Another shot far, far wide to the left. Petrucci, another goal kick coming up.
After the regular season, which will have 16 games, the playoffs will start on October 26th. And in order to win the OUA championship, Matt, you've got to win 4 straight games.
October 26th, that's my birthday.
That's your birthday, Matt?
Yeah, that's my birthday.
Well, hopefully we can be there to broadcast that game for you.
Yeah, that would be that'd be interesting.
Six of the 8 teams making the playoffs. The first 2 teams getting a bye.
The Blues here just trying to finish it off. Less than 2 minutes to go here in the game. Might be a minute or so of injury time left. I don't know if that's enough time for Lady V's. Lopez, ball out of bounds. Melnick bringing it into Lopez. Looks like, yeah, handball. On number 20, Hackett. It'll be the Blues ball. With just a couple minutes here to go.
And so far this season, the University Blues outscoring their opponents 11-1 on home field.
Free kick by Estorero. Wide and out of bounds. Looking for Lewis, however, a little bit too far for her.
Matt, 11 goals for...
McConville, sorry to cut you off quick there, Carson. I thought McConville was going to get an opportunity, but Lady V's quick to regain possession. Go ahead.
For a team that's, you know, prides itself on their defense, 11 goals in 4 games is a welcome sign of what should be a great run this year for the Blues.
Ball out of bounds.
Great goal crowd kick. Showing up here today.
Yeah, a lot of people out in the sun. See some umbrellas trying to stave off sunburn.
We Looks like use... a couple hundred people here today.
We'll get those statistics later on for you. As we said, a second game coming up here between the men. Same teams. UFT going up against Laurentian.
University of Toronto men's team, men's soccer team, are 1-1 on the season.
Laurentian bringing the ball in. However, unable to get anything set up as the Blues are just trying to keep the ball away from their net. Lopez trying to get something going against Miklovic. Diol sends the ball out of bounds, out of troubles, way, harm's way. Lady V's to bring it back in. Again, not much time left in this one here in the second half.
I think, Matt, you know, I know we've only watched 2 games, but this might have been the best game so far for the Blues in this young season. The teamwork, the little give-and-go plays.
And that wraps it up for us here at Varsity Stadium. The Blues with another win.
Toronto Varsity Blues 2, Laurentian Lady V 0. The University of Toronto's Faculty of Physical Education and Health would like to thank you for supporting OUA Women's Soccer. We'd like to remind you to stick around for Game 2, a men's match featuring the Laurentian Voyageurs and the University of Toronto Varsity Blues getting underway in approximately 20 minutes.
be too strung out on compliments. Overdosed on confidence. Started not to give a f and stop fearing the consequence. Drinking every night because we drink to my accomplishments. Made it way too long. I'm floating in and out of consciousness. And they saying I'm back. I'd agree with that. I just take my time with all this shit. I still believe in that. I had someone tell me I fell off. Ooh, I needed that. And they wanna see me pick back up. Well, where'd I leave it at? I know I exaggerated things. Nah, I